Welcome back to another NCAA 2023-24 video, and today we'll be having the week 3 matchup between the Michigan State Spartans and the Washington Huskies. And this is one of the most exciting games that I am hyped up for in college football, and it'll be a Big Ten matchup next season as Washington, Oregon, USC, UCLA will be joining the Big Ten, and we'll see all the other schools join the Big 12 and ACC that are in the Pac-12 this year besides Oregon State and Wazoo. What do you guys think about conference alignment in general? I know it's not a new concept, but I don't think it's really ever happened to a Power 5 school in this type of way. Let me know in the comments below. The Spartans get the ball to start off the game, and we have Noah Kim on 3rd-and-1 with a pitch option, but that play is blown up as there were so many Washington Huskies out in the backfield, and 3rd-and-inches now become 4th-and-4 at the 17-yard line, which will force the Spartans to have to settle for a field goal attempt in which their kicker will make it and go up by 3. So Michigan State are leading the Washington Huskies 3-0 after the first drive. We got Michael Penix and company here on 1st-and-10. Has a nice pocket and has the guy McMillan over the middle. And now that was a gain of 22 yards and are now at the 50-yard line, right at midfield. So just with one pass can change an entire game. And Penix is a lefty. I totally forgot about that, but that flips all the receiver routes, so that'll be interesting to adapt to. Here we got a 3rd-and-8 situation for Penix and UW. He scrambles to the left and has Odunze crossing to the left for a 15-yard reception and a first down. Out of the Pac-12 schools this year, who do you guys think will finish on top? I think you have 6 or 7 great options in Utah, Colorado, USC, Oregon, and UW, and Utah. So, also Oregon State, and a lot of the teams have to play each other this year, so I'm not sure if any team will come up with less than a loss, and I don't know if that'll be enough for them to qualify into the playoffs. I'm glad that the playoffs are expanding at the start of next year. Got McMillan crossing to the left for a first down, and a 31-yard reception for a first and goal at the 1. And this is a great opportunity for the Huskies to punch it in for a touchdown. Let's see what Michael Penix and company can do with the upcoming 3 downs. And on 2nd-and-goal, it's a quarterback sneak, and Michael Penix just jumps into the end zone. Reminds me of the positive thing happening to Jaden Daniels of LSU. You saw him go airborne and just get drilled to the ground, but Penix just prances into the end zone. And with that, Washington now leads 7-3 over the Michigan State Spartans. The Spartans have been making their way past through midfield, and Kim has some time in the pocket and gets it to his receiver Foster Jr. for a gain of 32 yards. And that was really close to the sideline, so let's see if he got a foot in bounds. And it might have looked like that right foot might have stepped outside. So looks like there will be no review and that he was in bounds. And so on 3rd-and-8, Kim tries to roll to his right and throw crossbody, but there was no completion there. And that brings up 4th-and-8 at the 10-yard lines, which will force the Michigan State Spartans to have to settle for a field goal right here. And with that make, the score is now 6-7 with Washington Huskies getting the ball and having the lead of 1. And on a 1st-and-10, Penix tries to force the ball into double coverage and is now picked off by Kimbrough, and the turnovers are 1-0 with Washington just throwing the first turnover of the game. And right around midfield and 1:40 remaining with 3 timeouts, Michigan State have put themselves in a good position to score before the end of the half. And we got Kalen DeBoer the Washington coach talking to his quarterback right there about that previous play. And the Spartans are now in the red zone on 3rd and 2 with a pitch option, but the Washington Huskies were there to snuff it out, and now it's a 4th and 4 at the 12. Washington decides to take a timeout with 39 seconds remaining in the half and forcing the Michigan State Spartans to have to settle for a field goal. But with that kick made, the Spartans now lead 9-7 over the Huskies. Michael Penix is looking to go for a drive with his team and completes a pass for 17 yards to Westover down the middle. Tries to go hurry up offense to stop the clock as much as possible. And with the Washington Huskies using the last of their 3 timeout, Penix tries to escape to the left but gets tackled inbounds, and that's going to run out the clock and force Washington to not be able to try and settle for a field goal attempt. And that's a costly 3 points that might haunt them at the end of the game. And with that, that is the end of the first half, end of the second quarter, with the Michigan State Spartans leading 9-7 over the Washington Huskies. The Huskies got the ball to start off the half, but get stopped, and 4th and 4 for the Spartans, but that's easily completed for 12 yards. The Spartans are quickly making their way downfield, and now are at the 22-yard line of the Washington Huskies. The Washington defense force a 4th and 11, but the Spartans decide to go for it, and Perriman picks it off in the end zone for an interception. And I don't know what Michigan was deciding to do. They probably should have gone for a field goal attempt. It was well within the range of their kicker, and they would have went up by 5. Washington is making their way down the field as slow as possible, trying to bite as much time from the clock as possible. And Penix passes it to McMillan for a 19-yard completion, which sets up a 1st and goal for the Huskies down at the 1. So with 4:09 remaining in the quarter, looks like the Washington clock management has been effective. And on 1st and goal, they decide to go for the sneak, and Penix is able to make his way towards the end zone, and now the score is 13-9, and it'll be interesting to see if they decide to go for 2 or for the field goal. They decide to go for 2, and Penix has a receiver wide open in the middle, Jalen Polk, to convert that 2-point conversion. Now Washington leads 15-9, taking a 6-point lead with 3:43 remaining in the game. The Michigan State quarterback got sacked a couple times, bringing up a 3rd and 21 situation, and Cook undercuts the pass and gets an interception right there. And with 1 first down, the game will be over. And on 2nd and inches, Penix decides to go with a quarterback sneak and gets the 1st down. And with that, the Washington Huskies can now take the victory formation and let the clock run out and win. And with the clock now striking 0, the Washington Huskies are going to go to Michigan State and take the game 15-9. Let me know in the comments below, who do you guys think will win, and what do you guys think the score will be in this real life matchup. If you like this type of content, we'll be covering college football all season long, so like and subscribe. Appreciate all the support, and we'll catch you in the next one. Take care.